Welcome to Book Time with Ryan. I am Ryan, and today I'll be doing the 2024 Mid-Year Freakout Tag. What? Did I scare you? I'm sorry. I'm joined by my one of my special co-hosts. This is Samantha. She may not last the entire time, but she is cute. And, and she's sweet. Okay. I've done this twice before, and I got this originally from Literature Science Alliance, which I'll include a link to that video, and I'll include a link to my video from last year. I've had this sitting around, not the video, the idea of doing this video for probably a month, and I created the thumbnail, and then I just kept not chickening out. I just didn't want to do it. I don't know why. Well, I wanted to do it, but I wrote it down. Okay. So I am going to be reading the questions and the prompts, which I'll include down in the description area. And I'm also going to look down for my answer so I don't have to think on the fly, because here's what I figured out with this tag that I'm not sure how I dealt with it in the past. I don't know how to break up my year for this tag. Are we doing a calendar year? Probably. But we could do it in the fiscal year. Or we could just, I don't know. Like, well, probably not fiscal year, right? Because, like, why? And the problem that I have is it asks for what am I looking forward to for the next half of the year, which there's less of the half. I realize it doesn't make total sense. Sammy, it's focused on you now. I'm out of focus. Was that you? Okay. But I feel like then I miss the first half of whatever year I'm doing. Like if I did from this date and a year later, and I just defined first half of the year or the year to, oh, is this gross to anybody? I like puppy kisses. If my year was defined by this video, and this was the midpoint, and I just said year three of BookTube with Ryan, this is what applies, that would make more sense. But I don't know. I looked at my old videos, and I'm not sure if I even thought about it. Or what? Because when I was going through and trying to figure out which books I had read, I've slowed down on my video production. I read some really long books, and that caused me, as a slow reader, to read less books. So there are less books to choose from, and that also means that some of the books that I read that missed the last freakout tag wouldn't have been mentioned in this freakout tag. And I just feel like that's missing out on some good extra freakout. All right, so I'm gonna read the prompts and the questions, and then I'll give you my answer. Where I can, I'll include a link to the video in the little pop-up thing that we have, but I think that's limited to 5, so that will stop pretty quickly. Okay, cool. Are we good? Yes, let's do this. Sammy, how are you doing? Are you doing okay? You want to look at the screen? Look here. Look at that. Oh. One of the answers is going to be a video about Sammy. I will definitely include a link to that video, because you got to check out her face in that video where she is a puppy, because she's not as much of a puppy anymore. But I am a puppy. I know you are. Okay. But she's much bigger now. And that video announced her as a special co-host. I'm giving it away already. Okay, number one. Best book you've read so far in 2024. Ilium by Dan Simmons. It got a pretty good number of views, too. It was, I don't know what I expected. It was long, and it was really well done. It was really well done, and you can watch the video about that, because I don't remember everything from it. Yeah. All right. Number two, best sequel you read so far in 2024. And also, I think Ilium was probably right at the end of 2023, but so this is like one of those early examples of I'm not sure what I want to do with the time frame. All right, number two, best sequel you've read so far in 2024. The Angel of Indian Lake or City in Ruins. These are actually sequels. These are the final books in trilogies the Jade. I forgot what her name was. Jade something. By Stephen Graham Jones. I hope I'm getting that right. And then City in Ruins was the final trilogy and final book by Don Winslow. I've done reviews for both of those. Number three. New release you haven't read yet, but want to. Oh, this shows how long I've been waiting to do this. Because I wrote Worst Case Scenario, which was, when I wrote this, a new release. But I took an extra week or two to do this tag, and I have since read this book. So maybe I shouldn't say that. Oh, I don't really have one for a new release that's already been released. Because the next question is what I would have picked now that I've read Worst Case Scenario. Number four, most anticipated release for the second half of the year. Easy. Carla's Choice by Nick Harkaway. This is Nick Harkaway's picking up the George Smiley character that was part of many of John Le Carre's books. Nick Harkaway is John Le Carre's son, also an amazing author. He has his own, actually they both have their own playlists on my channel. And Carla's Choice, I believe, takes place between The Spy Who Came In From the Cold and Tinker Tailor Soldier Spy. So later this year, I will be rereading the three books before this one is supposed to take place. Just to kind of be reminded of what was happening. And then maybe I'll even read Tinker Tailor Soldier Spy. And then it's like, where do I stop from there? Because then I could just read the trilogy, the Carla Chronicle trilogy. Oh, I'm getting bit now. Excuse me. Not appropriate. All right, let's see. Number five, biggest disappointment. My biggest disappointment was NFTs are a scam. NFTs are the future. Just, I don't know. Well, kind of fanboyish, it felt like. There wasn't a whole lot going on there. I didn't really have it. Not a big disappointment, but I just haven't had that many disappointments that I could even really classify as a disappointment. Oh, thank you. Sammy, you are not being very helpful, are you? Are you being helpful? All right. Number six. Biggest surprise. The Shadow on Wall Street. Done a review for that. I really liked it. I was not expecting that I would like it so much. And then I called the author after and talked to him a little bit. So, which you won't see, but I did that. And that was just a kind of a surprise book that was well done. And in my opinion, fairly accurate. At least with the kind of nonfiction elements. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Favorite new author, debut or new to you? See, now this is like one of those... I said Michael Crichton, and it's because, obviously, like, I've watched tons of Michael Crichton movies and shows. It's just, I finally read, in the last year, a Michael Crichton book, and that was Jurassic Park, and then Lost World, and a couple others, I think. And I enjoyed them. So there you go. There weren't a whole lot of options there. I read longer books of people that I had already read before, and they were not really new to me. What are you trying to do? Getting up? Right, getting up? All right. Newest fictional crush. None. I don't have a fictional crush. I'm 40. That's kind of I won't say weird, because I know people are sensitive to that word right now, but it's kind of weird. Or not. I don't really have a fictional crush. Newest favorite character? None.
Okay. Don't pee, though.
Hopefully she doesn't pee. Newest favorite character? None. Not really, that I can think of. I mean, there are characters I've really liked, but I just wouldn't, like, classify them as favorite. And there's probably a favorite of the new characters that I've met, but that does not mean that they are a favorite character now for me. Book that made you cry? None, but I will add that I did feel some emotions during Worst Case Scenario, and if I had not controlled myself more and had been in some other kind of mental state, maybe I would have cried, but I don't think so. And by the way, you can cry and not be sad. You can cry and just be touched. But I wasn't. Number 11. Book that made you happy. Love Wins. Love Wins is a religious book about the power of love and God's love for his people. And it was a thinking book, and I enjoyed it. And love winning should make you happy, because the opposite is not so great. Number 12, favorite book to film adaptation you saw this year? Shogun. And this says book to film, I'm saying book to show. I did a review of the book to show comparison kind of thing. I read Shogun, it's this big book here, and that was the media tie-in with the show. I really like the show too. And yeah, it was a long book, but it was good. And so was the show on FX. Apparently there's gonna be a season 2, which is weird because there's no book 2. And the show ended where the book basically ended. So I don't know how they're gonna do that. Number 13, favorite video you have done so far this year? Introducing our new special co-host, Samantha. This is the one I was referencing when I said, check out what Sammy looks like now and look at what she looked like when we introduced her. She just left the room, but you can go back and check out the video, because I will definitely provide a pop-up thing for it there. And she will be in some videos. It's just, she's not to interact. Like, there are very few times where I'm gonna need to be licked in the face to talk about a book. I can't think of any right now. And my other co-host is Noelia, and she will not be licking my face because she's my kid. All right, number 14, most beautiful book you bought so far this year or received? Shogun. I didn't really receive a whole lot of pretty books, but Shogun had a really nice cover, and that is 100% what this answer is about, just the cover. It was not all that special on the inside. Slim pickings, but Shogun was nice. And number 15, the final question. What books do you need to read by the end of the year? I don't need to read any books. I think I say that every time. I don't need to read anything. I did say, and I stand by this statement, that I am going to try to read the John le Carré books that take place before Carlo's Choice is set. Two of them are very short, so I am kind of giving myself a little more time before I start that, because I want to be fresh. But I don't really need to read anything else. There's also next year. This is kind of why I was thinking about what year are we talking about here. In March, Monarch, the book by Ryan Steck that picks up the character Alex Hawk from Ted Bell, who died a few years ago. That's going to be March. So if I am including that time period, Carla's Choice and Monarch are two books that I am very excited about, that I know are coming out and involve characters that I've loved for a long time. So there you go. This was probably a month later than I wanted it to be, but I did it. It's the third time I've done it, so it's one of the more consistent tag videos that I've had since I've been on BookTube, and I felt kind of prepared. And you got to see a puppy. She's 6 months old, a little over 6 months, so she's still a puppy. So, thank you for being here today. Oh, also, my thumbnail is from Midsummer. I'm not sure if you could tell, but that was a pretty crazy movie. And I have some Swedish blood in me, so it's even more appropriate. And that's it. Thanks a lot for being here. Have a good one. Goodbye. 'Cause I got issues, but you got them too. So give them all to me and I'll give mine to you. Bask in the glory of all our problems. 'Cause we got the kind of love it takes to suffer.